Welcome to all to LDL 3 called Lockdown Lecture 3. In a previous lecture, we have finished a mole concept relation, a quadrilateral rule for a mole concept. Also, at the end of the lecture, we have discussed the percentage proportion for a given element present in a compound. Today, we'll take another concept related to the relation of a molecular formula and an empirical formula. Let's see what is the meaning of molecular formula and empirical formula, or relation between molecular formula and empirical formula. To understand this topic, we'll take a molecular formula of glucose. You know that glucose has a molecular formula C6H12O6. We can write the formula of glucose in form of CH2O 6 times. Here this 6 is denoted as N means any whole natural number which can be taken common from the molecular formula. The provided CH2O is known as empirical formula. So now it's simple to understand that molecular formula MF is N into empirical formula EF and MF. MF is called molecular formula and EF is known as empirical formula. We can say that C6H12O6 is equal to CH2O6, where 6 N, N is equal to 6. It's a relation between molecular formula and empirical formula for any of the compound. We'll take some more example to understand the topic well. Another example is a diborane, a compound called B2H6. B2H6 is the molecular formula of borane, diborane. It's B2H6. Now I think you can derive an empirical formula. How? By taking 2 common, we'll get BH3 twice. Here N is equal to 2. That means molecular formula for a borane is equal to 2 times of its empirical formula, where N is equal to 2 for diborane. So it's a relation between molecular and empirical formula. For benzene C6H6, its empirical formula is CH, because we have N is equal to 6 for a benzene. So a relation between molecular formula and empirical formula is, molecular formula is N times, or MF called molecular formula is N times of its empirical formula. Now we'll discuss how to derive the empirical formula through percentage proportion. We'll take some example to understand the concept of a empirical formula and how can we derive a molecular formula from the empirical formula. For this purpose, we'll take some examples. He will help us to discuss this example. She will read the question for us. We'll discuss the relation of empirical and molecular formula through some examples. Question number 1. Here.
A substance on analysis give the following percentage composition.
When a substance gets analyzed, कोई एक compound हमारे पास है, उसको हमने analyze किया practically. और प्रैक्टिकली एनालाइज करने के बाद हमको पता चला कि ये कंपाउंड के अंदर कुछ एलिमेंट प्रेजेंट है और उनका परसेंटेज प्रोपोर्शन दिया गया है जो हीट बताएगी.
Na इक्वल टू 43.4%.
अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंपोजिशन और अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिजल्ट्स दैट वी हैव डिराइव्ड, सोडियम इज
43.4%
प्रेजेंट इन अ गिवन कंपाउंड.
कार्बन इक्वल्स टू,
कार्बन्स प्रोपोर्शन इज
11.3%.
Oxygen's proportion is
45.3%. Calculate its empirical formula.
EF called empirical formula. ये question है क्योंकि हमारे पास कि compound को जब हमने analyze किया तो उसमें 3 element पाए गए, sodium, carbon and oxygen, और उनका percentage proportion भी है. Make sure the total percentage proportion should be 100. इस सबको add करने के बाद आपको percentage proportion 100 मिलना चाहिए. जब आप इसको ऐड करोगे यू ऑब्जर्व दैट इट्स 100% प्रोपोर्शन। ये कॉन्स्टेंट को सिंप्लीफाई करने के लिए एक टेबल मैंने यहां पर बनाया हुआ है जिसमें कुछ कॉलम एंड रोज बनाए गए हैं। द फर्स्ट कॉलम विल पुट एलिमेंट्स इनटू इट, जो हमारे पास तीन एलिमेंट है सोडियम कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन, हम यहां पर उनको रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे सोडियम इन फॉर्म ऑफ Na, कार्बन कॉल C, देन वी हैव ऑक्सीजन O. The given percentage proportion of a sodium is 43.4%. For carbon it is 11.3%. And for oxygen it is 45.3%. Second column belongs to the percentage proportion given. The third column has atomic masses. We know atomic masses of some element. And I think you know sodium's atomic mass. It is 23. The atomic mass of carbon is 12 and that of oxygen is 16, you know it. The third column, we have to perform a relative ratio to calculate the number of moles. How can we calculate the number of moles? By dividing the percentage proportion through its atomic mass. So when percentage proportion gets divided with the atomic masses, percentage of carbon given 11.3 and the atomic mass of carbon is 12. Similarly, we have to divide 45.3% that oxygen's proportion with its atomic mass 16. The ratios are, here will help us, 43.4 divided by 23, here it is 1.88. You can use your calculator for the calculation, it's 1.88 ratio. For 11.3 divided by 12,
0.94.
0.94 and 45.3 divided by 16 is
2.83.
Now we are having three ratios, 1.88, 0.94 and 0.83 as a relative number of moles. From this relative number of moles, we have to derive a simple ratio. What to do to derive a simple ratio? It's the last column required. For simple ratio, we have to check out of these three, which one is the smallest value? The smallest value is 0.94. So, this value 1.88 should be divided by 0.94. For this one, 0.94 is divided by 0.94. And for the last row, 2.83 should be divided by 0.94. So, out of these three, the smallest ratio should be used. The first one, 0.88 divided by 0.94 is 2. The second ratio is 1. And the third ratio has a 3 as a whole number. You can observe, we reached to the complete whole number at the end of the calculation, which indicates that in a given compound, we have 2 sodium atoms because we have a simple ratio 2 for sodium. So we have 2 sodium atoms, 1 carbon atom and 3 oxygen atoms. So that's why our empirical formula for the given compound is sodium. How many sodiums we are having? 2. Carbon, how many carbons we are having? 1. And oxygen, how many oxygens are we having? 3. So the compound is Na2CO3. It's an empirical formula for the given compound. Again, when a compound gets analyzed, we have sodium, carbon and oxygen in the percentage ratio of 43.4, 11.3 and 45.3 respectively. The question is, we have to calculate the empirical formula. To calculate the empirical formula, we need a table in which the first column contains the elements, the second column has a percentage proportion given in a question. Third one is atomic mass, that you know very well, that sodium's atomic mass is 23. For carbon it is 12, for oxygen it is 16. The next column, we have a relative number of moles. To calculate the relative number of moles, we have to divide the percentage by atomic masses. So 43.4 divides by 23, will get 1.88. 11.3 divided by 12 will get 0.98. And 45.3 gets divided by 16 to have 2.83. This ratio should be converted into the simple whole numbers. So we need a simple ratios. For getting the simple ratio, what to do? You have to check out of these three ratios, which one is the smallest one? The 0.94 is the smallest one. So all the given values or the derived values should be divided by the smallest value called 0.94, 0.94, 0.94. Then we'll get a simple whole number in form of 2, 1, 3. That means sodium, carbon and oxygen are either present in proportion of 2:1:3. That means the compound contains 2 atoms of sodium, 1 atom of carbon and 3 atoms of oxygen to constitute the empirical formula Na2CO3. I think you understand this example very well. We'll take one more question, similar type of question. He will help us. He will read out the second question for the calculation.
What is the simplest formula of the compound which has the following percentage composition?
Just a minute. They ask us to find the simplest formula having following composition. Read out the composition.
Carbon equals to 80%.
80%.
Yeah.
Okay. So they provide us 80% of carbon present in the given compound.
And hydrogen equals to 20%.
Hydrogen 20%. That means the compound only possesses two elements. Simple. Again, what to do?
Its molecular mass is 30.
Okay. So they ask us to derive a simple formula, but the molecular mass of a given compound is 30. Okay.
Also, we have to calculate the molecular formula and empirical formula.
Okay. Molar mass is 30.
Yeah.
And empirical formula and molecular formula that we have to calculate. Okay. Same thing, we have two elements, carbon and hydrogen, so we'll put C and H. The percentage given are 80 and 20 respectively. The carbon atomic mass of carbon is 12, that of hydrogen is 1. Now what to do? We have to take a ratio. That means we have to divide a percentage proportion with atomic mass. So 80 divided by 12 and here 20 divided by 1. 80 divided by 12 is?
6.66.
6.66 or 6.67 we can say. And 20 divided by 1 is 20. Out of these two, which one is the smaller one?
6.66.
So we have to divide 6.66 by 6 and 20 by 6.66. The answer in the form of ratio is
1 and 3.
Yeah. Nearly equal to 3 or 3. So if we suggest that we have a compound in which the carbon and hydrogens are present in the proportion of 1:3, which indicates its empirical
formula.
Empirical formula. So we have empirical formula in form of a CH3 for a given compound. But we have an additional information in form of molar mass. In question, they have provided that molar mass of a given compound is 30 gram per mole. After getting the empirical formula, the next step to calculate empirical formula mass. जैसे molecular formula में हम molar mass find कर सकते हैं, वैसे ही empirical formula से हमको मिल सकता है empirical formula mass. हमारा empirical formula है CH3. So which contains 1 carbon and 3 hydrogens. 1 carbon whose atomic mass is 12. Hydrogen whose atomic mass is 1. So it is 12 plus 3 total 15 gram per mole. So we have empirical formula mass in form of 15 gram per mole. By using the relation of empirical formula mass and a molar mass, we'll get a value of N. N is equal to molar mass divided by empirical formula mass. Molar mass given is 30 Empirical formula mass is 15. So n is equal to 2. Here n is not equal to number of moles. Here n is a multiple that we have discussed. By using the value of n, we'll get a molecular formula. Molecular formula, the formula is, molecular formula is n times empirical formula. N. Empirical formula for the given question is CH3 and that value of n is 2. So we can say that the molecular formula is C2H6 and that's why the molecular formula for given compound is C2H6. This C2H6 is a hydrocarbon called ethane. Methane ka bada bhai hai ye ethane. Methane ka formula hai CH4. Methane se jo bada hydrocarbon hai wo hai ethane C2H6. तो ये था रिलेशन रिलेशन बिटवीन मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला एंड एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला. सो ये तरीके से आप मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला से एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला और एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूला से मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला डिराइव कर सकते हैं. कॉपी कर लीजिए और रेडी फॉर द थर्ड क्वेश्चन. Let's discuss the question number 3. Third question. Similar type of questions we are taking today for your practice. I'll also provide one assignment containing different type of questions related to this lecture for your improvement or for your betterment of your studies. You can use your calculator for the calculation. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन जो है वो आप सब मेरे साथ साथ सॉल्व करते जाओगे. तो अगर आपके पास कैलकुलेटर नहीं है, पॉज दिस लेक्चर, ब्रिंग योर कैलकुलेटर टू योर स्टडी टेबल. लेट्स सी द थर्ड क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3.
एन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड ऑन एनालिसिस गेव द फॉलोइंग डेटा.
वन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड व्हेन एनालाइज्ड गेव द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन. व्हिच आर दे?
कार्बन इक्वल्स टू 57.82.
The percentage of carbon is 57.82.
Hydrogen is 3.6%.
3.6% of hydrogen is present in it.
And the rest is oxygen.
Rest is oxygen remaining. Already mentioned, total must be 100%, correct? अगर आपको total 100% करना है, rest is oxygen, तो आपको rest मतलब 100 में से ये दोनों के total को क्या करना है? Minus. So deduct total of this 2% in proportion from 100. What we'll get? We'll get
38.58%
of oxygen, I think.
And its vapor density is?
One more thing has been given called vapor density. Now, what is the meaning of vapor density? I'll explain afterwards.
83.
It is 83. 83 is the vapor density called VD. VD is called vapor density. We'll discuss vapor density after calculation, but we'll first take the calculation. Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are present. So, the elements are C, H and O. And the percentage proportions are 57.82 given 3.6. We have derive the percentage of oxygen. How? By deducting the total from 100, because the total percentage proportion should be the 100 one. So the remaining or rest of oxygen they have suggested, that means 38.58% is the proportion of oxygen. Next column has atomic masses. Carbon's atomic mass is 12, that of oxygen, hydrogen is 1, oxygen is 16. Again, we have to take a ratio. 57.82 should be divided by 12. 3.6 divides by or divided by 1 and 38.58 divided by 16. The ratios are here.
4.81.
When we divide 57.82 with 12, what do you get?
4.8.
I think it's 4.81. Okay.
3.6.
It's 3.6 and
2.40.
Out of these three ratios, which one is the smallest one? It's 2.40. So we have to divide all the given ratios with the 2.40. 4.81 divided by 2.40, 3.6 divided by 2.40 or 4, and 2.4 divided by 2.4. The answer in the ratios are
nearly equal to 2.
Nearly equal to 2 will get, okay, for this
1.5.
It's 1.5
and
1. This time we are in dilemma. हमारे पास यहाँ पर जो रेशियोज आए वो 2:1.5:1 है, जहां पर एक रेशियो 1.5 है, इट्स नॉट अ होल नंबर. अगर ये होल नंबर नहीं है, क्या हम ये नंबर को होल नंबर में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं? हाउ? द नियरेस्ट होल नंबर कन्वर्जन ऑफ 1.5 इज 3, करेक्ट. 1.5 को आप 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करो, 1.5 टू जब 3 है ना. सो वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई ऑल दिस नंबर्स बाय 2 बाय 2 बाय 2 एंड द फाइनल विल गेट अ होल रेशियो. 2 2's are 4, 1.5 2's are 3, and 2 1's are 2. So our whole ratio now is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen are in the proportion of 4:3:2. Why we have to multiply with the 2? The reason is hydrogen present is not available in a whole ratio number. And that's why we have to convert into the molecular formula in a simple whole number. 1.5 should be multiplied by 2, and that's why if you multiply 1.5 by 2, we should have to multiply 2 and 1 also with the 2. Same ratio, same multiple should be there. And that's why we'll get 4:3:2. So molar formula, or we can say that the empirical formula first. Empirical formula that we are having, carbon's proportion is 4. Hydrogen is 3 and oxygen in the proportion of 2. 4:3:2.
Also calculate the molecular formula.
We have to calculate molecular formula. Molecular formula. The molecular formula we can derive from empirical formula. We know that molecular formula n times empirical formula. So molecular formula is n times empirical formula. We are successful to derive, or we have a success to derive the empirical formula. But to derive a molecular formula from empirical formula, we need value of n. We know that n is equal to molar mass divided by empirical formula mass. It's a ratio of molar mass and empirical formula mass that can provide us value of n. Last question में हमको molar mass दिया गया था, अगर तुमको याद हो तो 30 as a molar mass, और हमने empirical formula mass derive किया था 15. So 30 divided by 15 is 2, और हमने n की value 2 use करी थी. यहां हमारे पास molar mass की कोई information नहीं है, लेकिन एक और important बात बताई थी, क्या? Vapor density, VD. मैंने कहा था कि VD के बारे में बाद में discuss करेंगे. Vapor density. What is the relation of vapor density with the molar mass? एक और important relation है, that molar mass of any compound is 2 times its VD. Molar mass is always 2 times of vapor density. तो कोई भी compound की अगर vapor density दी जाती है, तो उससे आप उसका molar mass easily derive कर सकते हो. How? We have to multiply vapor density by 2. So now it is 2:83. 2:83 is
166.
It's 166 gram per mole. So molar mass of a given compound is 166. So by using the molar mass 166 and the empirical formula mass, we can derive value of n. How can we calculate the empirical formula mass? You know that calculation of empirical formula mass. How can we calculate the empirical formula mass? Let's see. Empirical formula mass for which compound? It is C4H3O2. So 4 carbon, 3 hydrogens and 2 oxygens we are having. Carbons are having mass 12, hydrogen 1, oxygen 16. 12 for that?
48.
Plus?
3.
Plus?
32.
Total?
83.
83. So 83 is the empirical formula mass. 83 is an empirical formula mass. So by using 83 as empirical formula mass, we'll get n is equal to 2. We'll get
n is equal to 2.
And that's why by putting the value of n over here, the final answer is C8H6O4 is a required molecular formula for a given compound. तो ये तरीके से आप कोई भी molecular formula derive कर सकते हो. It's a relation of molecular formula with empirical formula through percentage proportion. बहुत important concept है ये. फिर से एक बार समझ ले. Molecular formula is n times of empirical formula. How can we get a value of n? N is a ratio of molar mass upon empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass calculate करें, molar mass, empirical formula mass का जो ratio है वो n provide करेगा. एक और important concept भी हमने last question है, called vapor density. Vapor density से molecular mass available हो सकता है. Molecular mass is 2 times vapor density. तो ये था percentage proportion और molecular formula और empirical formula mass का calculation. मेरे ख्याल से ये पेस ठीक है, किसी को बहुत जल्दी लगा हो तो लेक्चर को 2-3 एक बार ध्यान से देखें और कॉन्सेप्ट बहुत सिंपल है, ठीक से समझें, कैलकुलेटर का इस्तेमाल करें. और ये क्वेश्चन जो है वो एग्जाम के लिए 4 का हो सकता है, 4 क्वेश्चन, न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चन. सो बहुत सिंपल क्वेश्चन है, ध्यान से सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. और आज के लिए इतना काफी है.